Is it doing the public?
There's no blessing?
Oh, there might be. There is.
Yeah, because you can have like a blessing for the community.
Then what can we do that next to you?
Does he even respond? Yeah.
Can we even do it? But I'm sure you must have.
Maybe I didn't have, I didn't even have a chance to.
Please rise. Sing to God a hymn of praise. He who on the cross as Savior for the world salvation led. Jesus Christ, the King of glory, now is risen from the dead.
Good evening.
Good evening, Father.
Welcome to everyone to take part in this Holy Eucharistic celebration. Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, as we have gathered here as a God's family, let us acknowledge our sins and ask our Lord's pardon and mercy to take part in this Holy Eucharist.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Have mercy,
Lord, have mercy,
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Glory to God in the highest, glory to God, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father.
Glory to God in the highest, glory to God, and on earth
Jesus Christ, only begotten Son. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us.
Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Almighty our living God, constantly accomplish the Paschal mystery within us, that those you were pleased to make new in holy baptism may under your protective care bear much fruit and come to the joys of life eternal. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. As the number of disciples continued to grow, the Hellenists complained against the Hebrews because their widows were not being neglected in the daily distribution. So the 12 called together the community of the disciples and said, "It is not right for us to neglect the word of God to serve at table. Brothers, select from among you 7 reputable men, filled with the Spirit and wisdom, whom we shall appoint to this task, whereas we shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word." The proposal was acceptable to the whole community, so they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented this man to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and the number of the disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As we place our trust in you.
be on us as we place our trust in you.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp, with a ten string lyre chant his praises.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
Upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Lord, let your mercy be on us as we place our trust in you.
See, the eyes of the Lord are upon those who fear him, upon those who hope for his kindness, to deliver them from death and preserve them in spite of famine.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, come to him, a living stone, rejected by human beings, but chosen and precious in the sight of God. And like living stones, let yourselves be built into a spiritual house, to be a holy priesthood, to offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For it says in Scripture, behold, I am laying a stone in Zion, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in it shall not be put to shame. Therefore, its value is for you who have faith. But for those without faith, the stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone, and a stone that will make people stumble, and a rock that will make them fall. They stumble by disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of his own, so that you may announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I am the way, the truth, and the life, says the Lord. No one comes to the Father except
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me, says the Lord. Good evening, my brothers and sisters. Are we saved, all of us? Yes. A few weeks ago, we celebrated Easter, which is the major feast of our Christianity. We celebrated the Paschal mystery of Christ Jesus. So, the truth is that we are all saved by the grace of God, and it's been continued that we are being saved by God, God's grace and his mercy. And God is always with us. And we have to follow him, and we need to understand him, and we need to realize what he is. As we are saved, that always we need to think that it is not something that we gained by ourselves, but it is the free gift that God has given us, the faith which we had in God, in Jesus. And we are all saved by the grace and mercy of God through baptism. Yes, my brothers and sisters, as it is said, I am the way and the truth and the life. Yes, Jesus alone is the way. There is no other way to enter into the glorious kingdom of God. And we need to follow him, though it is narrow way, though it is very difficult, but we need to follow it. The truth is that we need to understand the importance of our salvation is that we are saved by the death of Jesus Christ through his passion, his death and resurrection. He saved us by this Paschal mystery. So he is the life for us. He has given us life by dying himself on the cross. So he is our life. And that is true. And we are all called to live a holy life. And most of the times we think that we are saved because of our good works. Sometimes it is yes, at the same time it is no. It is not that we are saved by our good works. Yes, which is true, all that we do, good works, they accompany with us in order to enter into the kingdom of God. They are counted. But without Jesus, we can do nothing. With Jesus, we can gain anything and everything. Even if you would like to do good things, that we need to have Jesus in our life. So Jesus is full of life. It is not that we are saved by our good works. And at the same time, we say, it is no. Why? Because without Jesus, we are not saved. So we need to do good things and good works in order to be saved. When we follow in the footsteps of Jesus on his way to receive the life in fullness, and we need to understand that is the truth of life, that is Jesus alone. That's what he says. I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to me and to the Father except through me. It is only happens that we are saved through Jesus Christ. So therefore, my brothers and sisters, let us reflect upon this, that if you would like to be saved, have faith in God, have faith in Jesus, and you should understand what Jesus is. He is calling every one of us to focus on him. He is our center of life. Jesus is the center of all of our lives. So therefore, let us focus on Jesus. Receive him into your lives. And accept him as our Lord and Master, our Savior, and follow his way to the eternal life. Amen. My brothers and sisters, let us profess our faith by reciting the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, as a chosen race and a royal priesthood, let us take the needs of our world before the throne of our loving God.
For our church to continue to reach out to those on the margins of society and to show the world how to care for even the least and of our midst, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For peaceful resolutions to the challenges that face our world, such as hunger, poverty, climate change, and especially the coronavirus pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healthcare workers and all who are caring for the needs of those who are suffering from COVID-19, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our mothers, grandmothers, aunts, and all those who have mothered us, those who are living and those who have passed on to eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, for all who suffer from coronavirus, and for all who have died, especially Jessica Garcia and Noah Paul Amaya, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our mothers who have given us life and love, that we may show them reverence and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers who have lost a child through death, that their faith may give them hope and their family and friends support and console them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers who have died, that God may bring them into the joy of his kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray Father Mario Fumagalli, who passed away on this day, who helped me to reach out to the altar to celebrate the Eucharist, who raised me since my childhood until joining in the seminary. Let us remember him and pray for him, for his soul may rest in peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty God, You have called us out of darkness into a wonderful light. Hear these prayers that we bring to you today and graciously grant them according to your holy will. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Made by the Lord, let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord, let us rejoice in salvation. I thank you, your love is eternal. You have given me life, you have given me life. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation. Your hand raised me up in triumph. You have given me life, you have given me life. I will proclaim the wonders you do. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice, let us be glad. This day was made by the Lord. Let us rejoice in salvation.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. By the oblation of this body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross, and by commanding himself to you for our salvation, showed himself the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, overcome with the paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna. Blessed is he who comes in the name, the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be cohesed to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
"Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am He. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadow of the night, I will be your light. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you when you are mine. Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to you, your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Today, as we are celebrating Mother's Day, I would like to invite all the mothers and grandmothers to stand in your place for God's blessing. Others, you can extend your hands over mothers and grandmothers. Let us pray. God our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women, our mothers and grandmothers, that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
It must have been colder in my shadow to never have sunlight on your face. You are content to let me shine, that's your way. You always walk a step behind. So I was the one with all the glory, while you were the one with all the strength. Beautiful face without a name for so long. A beautiful smile to hide the pain. Did you ever know that you're my hero? And everything I would like to be. I can fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. Did you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I wish I could be. I could fly higher than an eagle, 'cause you are the wind beneath my wings. Thank you, thank you, thank God for you, the wind beneath my wings.
At this moment, let us respect our mothers, remember their love, sacrifice, and their affection for their children. Let us give them a big applause. We wish you all mothers a very happy Mother's Day. God bless you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you. The Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace of Christ and glorify the Lord by your life.
Thanks
be to God.
Have a wonderful weekend.
Thank you, Father.
God bless.
The fear now, vanish are my tears now, Jesus pass away, resucitó, resucitó, resucitó. Resucitó.